Dear students, now today we are going to discuss about some important results in probability. So, probability में आगे बढ़ने के लिए कौन से result हैं जो बहुत ही important हैं? So, the first result is कि for any two events A and B, P of A bar intersection B. A bar means this is disjoint set of A. So, A bar intersection B is equal to PB minus P of A intersection B. Second important result is ki if B is contained in A, then P A intersection B bar is equal to P of A minus P of B and P of B is less than or equal to P of A. Bar means you know the complement of A. Okay, if this is the set A, then outside of A is complement of A. So that is A bar. Now if third result is ki P of A intersection B is less than or equal to PA and PB and PA intersection B is less than or equal to PB. If A and B are two events, then PA union B is equal to PA plus PB minus PA intersection B. And this result may be written in these three way. Okay, either this or this PA or B is equal to PA plus PB minus PA and B, or sometimes some authors, some teacher, they also say like this, ki PA plus B is equal to PA plus PB minus PA into B. Okay, if AB, this is generalization of this result is, if AB and C are any three units, then PA union B union C is equal to PA plus PB plus PC minus PA intersection B minus P, B intersection C minus P, C intersection A plus P, A intersection B intersection C. So please remember these important results for probability. These are the basic results. Okay. Now one example, basic example we will look. A card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack of playing cards. Playing cards, it means playing cards, you must remember ki how many cards, 52, and there are four colors, 13 each. Okay. And what is the name of the color? You have at least you might be knowing. Otherwise, you must remember all these things first. What is the probability that it is either a spade or an ace? So let us consider A is the event of drawing a spade and B is the event of drawing an ace. And A and B are not mutually exclusive. Then AB is event of drawing the ace of a spade. So you can just total number of cards are 52 and the one color spread is 13 as so 13 by 52 PB similarly here the 4 this is favorable and 52 total so PB is 4 by 52 then PAB is already it is given that is 1 by 52 now just you put all these results and you will get PA plus B that is 4 by 13. In this way, you got what is the probability that it is either a spade or an S. So 4 by 13 is the probability. Similarly, you can do the another example and some other facts also, important facts on probability. What do you mean by conditional probability? Conditional probability means when we want the probability of an event from a conditional distribution, we write PB divides A. And pronounce as if probability this we say like this the probability of B given A again I am saying the probability of B given A this is the correct sometimes we call it P, B divides A but that is not the correct pronunciation the correct is the probability of B given A the probability that take into account a given condition is called the conditional probability. Now, for example, to find the probability of the event B given the event A, we restrict our attention to the outcome in A. We then find in what fraction of those outcome B also occurred. So P B given A is equal to P of A and B divided by PA. Note PA cannot equal 0 since we know that A has already occurred. Okay. So we must remember what is the meaning of conditional probability. Now, independence. What is the independence in probability? Independence of two events means that the outcome of one event does not influence the probability of the other. This is the actual meaning in probability. With our new notation for conditional probability, we can now formalize this definition. Event A and B are independent whenever P B given A is equal to P B. Equivalently, event A and B are independent whenever P A given B is equal to P A. Okay, when two events A and B are independent, we can use the multiplication rule for independent event, and that is very famous. P A and B is equal to P A cross P B. However, when our events are not independent, this earlier multiplication rule does not work. Therefore, we need the general multiplication rule, and that is this: if P A and B is equal to P A cross P B, event B given A, and P A and B is equal to P B multiplied by P of A given B. Okay, so this is about the mutually general multiplication rule. This does not matter. This has no wrongly it is written here. You add this. Now let us look one example. Okay, A has two. This example two. A has two shares in a lottery in which there are three prizes and five blanks. B has three shares in a lottery in which there are four prizes and six blanks. So that A's chance of the success is to B. Chance of success is 27:35. So this problem is based on simple mathematics, very simple mathematics. How? Let us consider A may draw two tickets out of the total given. Total given are 3 + 5 = 8. So how many ways? So this is 8C3. 8C3, or you can write 8C3. You know the combination. How to calculate? Then you will get after calculation. You know na NCR. NCR. What is NCR? Factorial n. Divided by factorial n divided by factorial n minus r. The 8C3 NCR. So with the definition of NCR, you will find by calculation, you will find the formula, and you will get that is at 8C3 means 28 number of ways. The A will get the blanks in 5C2 way is 10 ways. 5C2 means 5 × 4 / 2. So 5 × 4 / 2. Now hence A's chance for success is 18/28. B can draw three tickets in how many ways? 10C3. The 10C3 means 100. 10C3 means 120 way. Okay, and then B will get the blank in 6C3 way means 20 ways. B can win a prize in 120. How many? 120 minus 20. It means 120 minus 20 means 100 number of ways. As B's chance of success is 100/120, that is 5/6, and A chance is to B chance is 9/14. Already you calculated here. So this is 9/14 from here, and 5/6, 9/5, 9/14 is 5/6. That is 27/35. In this way, you have calculated how we can solve such problems.